Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly and shortly how to add text and subtitles with CyberLink PowerDirector 14. Please enable our closed captions by clicking on the CC icon in the video corner if you have problems understanding the accent. Let's see how to add simple text. There are two kinds of titles you can import in your project: 2D text and 3D text, both collected inside the title room in the top left corner. Before going on, it is important to understand the difference between title clips and title templates. Title clips are pieces of text imported in your project and completely independent each other. Title templates, instead, are pieces of text saved inside PowerDirector and not imported inside a single project. These are used to save a particular set of text properties that you can use as many times as you want and in any project you like. You just have to drag and drop a title template to create a title clip with its same title properties. At first, you won't have so many title templates. To add a new one, simply click on the first button on top and choose 2D title to start with a 2D text. This opens a dialog box called Title Designer, used to edit your text fully. We will see it shortly. Once you complete and save your title template, you can drag and drop it on your project to create a title clip with its same properties. Title clips can be dropped in both video and title tracks. Title tracks are recommended since, being at the very bottom of all video tracks, text is always visible and not covered by any video. Then, the title clip is equal to all other clips seen in the beginner tutorial. You can move, stretch, and shorten it working directly from the timeline. The only difference is that the opacity envelope is not present. To add transparency and set all the title properties of such clip, you need to use the Title Designer that you can open double-clicking on the clip interested. The Title Designer is composed by different parts. In the top right corner, you have a preview of your title clip over the whole project in progress. Through this, you can edit text directly. For example, you can type inside, drag the text to move it, or use its white nodes to scale and its green ones to rotate. On the left, you have more advanced properties you can apply to your text. Adjust all basic text and font properties like style, size, color, and distribution under the Text tab. These settings are applied on the whole text unless you select a piece from the preview. Under Font Face, adjust blur and opacity on text. Check Reflection to add a reflection effect and then adjust its opacity and distance. You can also apply shadow and borders on text going to Font Shadow and Border. Check and uncheck to enable and disable these effects. To check better how your text is going on, hold Ctrl down and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out on the preview. You can also use Ready Templates under Character Presets. Below the preview, you have a timeline that lasts throughout all the title clip that is being edited. This lets you add the keyframes used to apply effects and modifications in time. If you are interested in effects and keyframes, check out our related video in this guide. Title clips are not at all simple clips with single pieces of text inside. These can be advanced, containing more pieces of text, particles, images, and backgrounds, all inside a single clip. On top of the preview, click on the first icon to add more pieces of text. Add particle effects through the second icon. Use the third button to import images that you can move, scale and rotate as seen for simple text, and adjust through the options under image settings on the left. If you ever mistake, remember to use Ctrl and Z to undo your latest action. Each object imported adds a row inside your timeline below. If you want to remove any object, simply right-click on its row and go to Remove. This timeline works just like the main timeline, setting the order of visibility of all objects. You can adjust this order, pulling up or down each object as you like. Through the Title Designer, you can also apply effects and motion on each object inside the title clip. On the left, click on the Effect tab to add transitions used to make the text appear under Starting Effect and disappear under Ending Effect. Select the effect interested to apply it on the clip and check it through the preview on the right. To regulate the duration of each transition, simply drag the edges of the dark sides from the timeline. The left one represents the duration of the starting effect, while the right one the ending effect. You can also apply motion on the title clip through the Motion tab. This changes the position of the text in time, following different paths and adding keyframes on the position property row. If you want to discover more about effects and keyframes, check out our video in our channel. Mind that both effects and motion can be applied just on titles only. To apply all the modifications on text, just click on Save below. If you want to create 3D text, you have to start from a 3D text template, choosing 3D-like title when you create a new title template and drag and drop it on your project to use it. As seen for 2D titles, you can adjust all text properties through the Title Designer. In this case, you won't have the Motion tab anymore, but you will have in addition some important 3D options available. For example, go to 3D Rotation Settings to adjust the 3D point of view. Use 3D Texture Settings to apply 3D Filling, or 3D Settings to adjust the Zoom. To adjust the Extrusion level, go to Font Face. If you want to apply transitions, go to the Effect tab. Remember to render using 3D options in Produce, in case you want to obtain the maximum from your 3D titles. Inside Power Director, you can also add subtitles to your video through the Subtitles room. This lists all lines inside your video, with start, end time, and text under subtitle text for each line. Below, use the plus icon to add a new line that you can edit double-clicking on each side. The new subtitle will be added inside a subtitle track that will contain each of your subtitle lines just like simple clips on the timeline that you can move to change their start and end time, or stretch to change their duration easily, or remove right-clicking on them. If you want to change the text style to use for your subtitles, simply click on the T icon at the bottom and adjust all text settings. If you already have your subtitles ready, you can import them clicking on the first button in the bottom right corner. Use the second button to export the subtitles created with Power Director outside. Thanks for watching this video. Have a look in our full guide if you want to learn more for CyberLink PowerDirector 14.